गुड मॉर्निंग माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर फिट एंड हेल्थी। सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हियर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी चैप्टर जेनेटिक्स। सो लेट अस सी व्हाट इज द कंटेंट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर यू विल बी स्टडिंग। यू विल स्टडी अबाउट द थ्री लॉज ऑफ मेंडल, देन यू विल स्टडी अबाउट मोनोहाइब्रिड क्रॉस, डाईहाइब्रिड क्रॉस। Then you will also learn about the terms such as gene, allele, heterozygous, homozygous, dominant, recessive, mutation, variation, phenotype and genotype. Then after that you will study about sex determination in human, and at the end you will learn about sex-linked inheritance of diseases that include set X-linked characters like hemophilia and colorblindness. So let us start with the first topic, that is, what is heredity? So what do you mean by heredity? Heredity means you should have a question that why do some children, they are looking like their parents? Then why do some brothers and sisters, they are resembling each other? The answer to this question is simple, that is, it is because of the heredity. So heredity, it is the phenomena of transfer of the characters of traits. Traits means the characters that are passed from parents to offspring, and or you can say that the transfer of characters from one generation to the next generation, it is referred to as heredity. The another term for heredity is inheritance. Inheritance means you have inherited the characters from your parents, and it means it is the phenomena of transfer of character states from parents to offspring or from one generation to the next generation. So it is known as heredity, or another term for heredity is inheritance. Then the next term is, you should know, it is, what do you mean by variation? Variation simplifies that it means the differences or the dissimilarities which are present between progeny, that is between brother and sister, and between parent and offspring. So the dissimilarities or the differences is referred to as variation. Then the next topic is about genes. You have already studied what is gene. It is a segment of DNA. So here you will learn about that the genes, they are acting as a basic unit of heredity, means they are acting as a units for which there will be transmission of characters from parents to offspring, and therefore they are known as basic unit of heredity. The genes, they determine the development and expression of the inherited character of an organism. Therefore, they are known as the basic unit of heredity. Now, the another term, that is, who has coined this term, who has given this term gene? It was given in 1909 by Johansson. So here you are observing the diagrammatic view of DNA, gene and chromosome. You can see here a gene, it is a short segment of DNA in a chromosome. The genes, they are always associated with some character, and genes, they are present on the chromosome in a linear fashion. So the chromosomes, they are the heredity vehicles. They are acting as a vehicles for the transmission of the genes, that is characters from parents to daughter cell, and therefore the chromosomes, they are referred as hereditary vehicles. And you can see here in this diagram that the chromosomes, they are contained within the nucleus of the cell, and a gene, it is a short segment of DNA, as you can see in the diagram, and the histones, they are the proteins that are associated with the DNA. So a chromosome basically means it consists of nucleoprotein. That is, it is made up of DNA and the basic proteins, that is histone. So the genes, they are the unit of heredity, and however the chromosomes, they are acting as hereditary vehicles for the transmission of characters from parent to offspring. Then the next topic is, what is its genetics? It is the study of pattern of transmission of character from parents to offspring. And the term genetics, it was first introduced by a scientist named as Bateson in 1905. Now you will learn the most important scientist in the field of genetics, and his name is Johann Mendel. So here you will study about the Mendel and his hybridization experiments. He was the first to explain how the transmission of character from parent to offspring take place. So therefore he is referred to as father of genetics. So the term genetics, it was introduced by a scientist named as Bateson. However, the father of genetics is known as Mendel. Now he has given his hybridization experiments. So he has worked on garden pea, that is on Pisum sativum, and in his crossbreeding experiment he has selected 7 pair of contrasting characters in garden pea. So what are those 7 pair of contrasting characters? Let us see. First pair is of plant height. So the first character, that is plant height, here the dominant trait is tall and the recessive trait is dwarf. Then the second character, as you can see here in this picture, the second character is flower position, and the dominant trait is axial and the recessive trait is terminal. Then the third character which he has taken is of flower color, and the dominant trait of flower color is purple and the recessive trait is of white. Then after that he has taken the pod shape, and here the dominant trait is inflated and the recessive one is constricted. Another trait which he has studied is of pod color, and the dominant one is green and the recessive trait of this pod color is yellow. Then he has also studied the seed shape, and the dominant trait is round and the recessive one is wrinkled. And he has also studied the seed color. Here the dominant trait is yellow and the recessive one is green. So he has studied all these traits, and he studied inheritance of one pair of contrasting characters at a time. So the next we will study in next class. So this is all for today. Take care everyone.